गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डू द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्रीज़ लेसन 6, रिमेनिंग पार्ट दैट इज़ पेज 78-79। हाउ कैन वी कंट्रोल एनवायरमेंटल डिग्रेडेशन? इट मे बी अ 5 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन। आंसर यू विल राइट इट देयर। वी कैन कंट्रोल एनवायरमेंटल डिग्रेडेशन बाय द फॉलोइंग वेज। नंबर वन, मिनिमाइजिंग यूज वाटर फॉर प्रोसेसिंग बाई री यूजिंग एंड रीसाइकलिंग इट इन टू और मोर सक्सेसिव स्टेजेस। नंबर बी, हार्वेस्टिंग ऑफ रेन वाटर टू मीट वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग टू कलेक्ट द रूफ टॉप वाटर एंड अलाउ इट थ्रू द पाइप टू गेट इट कलेक्टेड इन द अंडरग्राउंड वाटर and that will be utilized in the form of rainwater harvesting. Next is treating hot water and effluents before releasing them in rivers and ponds. By treating the hot waters and other effluents in the STP, sewage treatment plant, and there the solid materials will be separated, hot water will be cooled down, and then it will be allowed to get drained in the rivers, lakes or ponds. Number D, treatment of industrial effluents can be done in 3 phases. First is primary treatment by mechanical means, which involves screening, grinding, flocculation and sedimentation. Screening means separating the solid substance of bigger size by setting up nets on the passage of water. Grinding means crushing the stones with the help of grinders into smaller particles that will mix up with the water. Flocculation means separating the solid substances which are lighter and float on the water. And sedimentation, allowing the heavier particles to settle down in the water. Second is secondary treatment by biological process, in which the hyacinths and other aquatic plants will be allowed to grow that will filter the water normally and naturally. Tertiary treatment by biological, chemical and physical process, in which involves recycling of waste water again and again by various methods. Next is there question 2. Discuss the steps taken by NTPC to minimize pollution. It is 1 into 5 5 marks question. Optimum utilization of equipment, adopting latest techniques and upgrading existing equipments, means to use the latest technology, latest machines and upgrading the old machines to utilize more for purifying the things like the pollutants which are been released in the air. Maybe the air pollutants which can be reduced by setting up the smoke precipitators in the chimneys. Like this, many other equipments are there which can be utilized to minimize pollution. Second is there, minimizing waste generation by maximizing ash utilization. The ash can be utilized by recycling the ash in other industries for making tiles and other things. In this way, the waste generation will be minimized. Providing green belts by nurturing biological ecological balance, addressing the question of special purpose vehicles for afforestation. Means special vehicles can be utilized for afforestation, planting more and more trees, so that more oxygen will be released, more carbon dioxide will be absorbed by the trees. That green belts will minimize the air pollution level. Number D, reducing environmental pollution through ash pond management, ash water recycling system and liquid waste management. Ash pond system means a pond like structure will be dug around the thermal power plants. Then all these ashes will be dumped over there, and then these ashes will be covered by soil or earth, and over the upper layer, trees and plants will be planted, so greenery will come back and the ashes will not get the free exposure to the rain from the rainwater or wind, and it will not degrade any soil. Ecological monitoring reviews online database management for its all power projects. Means they are keeping all database management about the incoming of coal, release of carbon dioxide, release of energy, release of oxygen by the trees, how much pollution level has been controlled. Every minute detail they keep it on their database, and this is called their database management system. Now let us discuss the back exercises of page 79. MCQ question number 1 is cement, you will encircle it. Number 2 is sail. Number 3 is aluminium. Number 4 is electronic. Then short question answer question number 2. First one is there in page 65. Second one is there in page 66. Third one is there in page 66. Fourth one is there in page 67. And fifth one is there in page 75. Then third part, long question answer, first question, page number 73 and 74. Second question, page 78. Third question is there, page 78, 79. Then activity, page number 8. First one is power. Second one is worker. Third one is market. Fourth one is retailer. Fifth one is product. Sixth one is manufacturer, seventh one is pollution. Now one project question is there in below that only you see project work. You select one from agro-based industry and one from mineral-based industry. Let us mark the agro-based industry as jute industry. Raw materials require jute. Other inputs, labor, electricity. Environmental norms, do they follow or not? No. Second category, you write mineral based industry, iron and steel industry. So there you write raw materials, iron ore, coal, limestone, so many things are there. Other imports, labor and electricity. Environmental norms, sometimes they follow, some of them they follow it. Okay. Then below the yellow box, quiz questions are there. First one is agro-based industry, second one is sugarcane, third is jute, fourth is steel, fifth is Bhilai steel plant, sixth is diesel locomotive works, DLW, Varanasi. Diesel locomotive works, Varanasi. Kindly do these questions in your classwork copy along with some additional homework questions. Okay. Thank you.